द स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू यू?
यस सर।
ओके
यस सर।
सो टुडे विल स्टार्ट विद द सिस्टम ट्रांसड्यूसर्स। Now, as you know that there's a transducer, you already know in measurements of what it is. It will actually gives us the information, or it will gives us the measurement. So as you know, the fact that as we have already discussed the current CT, current transformer, and this potential transformer CT and the PT, that is, it forms a very important link between the power system and the protective system. That is, whatever the information that we want, we want from this this CT and the PT from the high voltage system, we can get that information. So these transducers extract the information regarding the current and the voltage which is under protection, and pass it to the protective relays. And then while doing this, they insulate the low voltage system. They insulate the low voltage system, that is protective system. Low voltage protective system with the high voltage power system. So in the last lecture, one student told me that he won't understand this. If I can deliver the lecture in Hindi only, the Hindi also, it is also good. So I can use both the languages. So as जैसे system transducers क्या करता है, एक जब भी हम प्रोटेक्टिव सिस्टम को कनेक्ट करते हैं हाई वोल्टेज सिस्टम के साथ, तो हमें किस चीज़ की ज़रूरत होती है? हम बेसिकली, हमें एक हाई वोल्टेज और लो वोल्टेज सिस्टम को हमें इंसुलेट करना होता है. तो फॉर दैट वी आर एक्चुअली यूजिंग दिस करंट ट्रांसफार्मर एंड द पोटेंशियल ट्रांसफार्मर, और इनको हम सिस्टम ट्रांसड्यूसर्स भी कहते हैं. सो फर्स्ट इज द करंट ट्रांसफार्मर. So what are the different jobs that current transformer has to do? The first job of this current transformer is the step down the current, step down the current. It steps down the current to such a level that it can easily handle by the relay. So वो स्टेप डाउन करता है करंट को, ताकि वो इजीली रिले हैंडल कर ले. जनरली अगर आप सीटी की जो स्टैंडर्ड सो इट्स जॉब इज टू स्टेप डाउन द करंट टू द लेवल विच इज यूज्ड बाय द रिले. एंड द स्टैंडर्ड वैल्यूज दैट इज सेकेंडरी वैल्यूज आर 5 एम्पियर एंड 1 एम्पियर. सेकेंडरी जो स्टैंडर्ड वैल्यूज हैं 5 एम्पियर और 1 एम्पियर हैं. अब सो व्हाई दिस स्टैंडर्ड्स आर चूजन, दिस स्टैंडर्ड्स आर चूजन सो दैट इट फ्रीज द डिजाइनर फ्रॉम द एक्चुअल वैल्यू ऑफ द प्राइमरी करंट. प्राइमरी करंट की वैल्यू जो भी हो, डिजाइनर हमेशा चूज करता है कि सेकेंडरी की वैल्यू हमारे पास 5 एम्पियर है एंड आर 1 एम्पियर है, जो हम प्रोटेक्टिव सिस्टम के साथ यूज करेंगे. सो फर्स्ट हो गया, ये स्टेप डाउन करता है, इट विल स्टेप डाउन. एंड सेकेंड इज, second thing is that what it does, it isolates the relay circuit that I have already discussed. So what it does, it isolates the low voltage protective system circuit or the relay circuit with the high voltage power system सर्किट वो दोनों को आइसोलेट करता है. ओके, नाउ हियर दिस डायग्राम इज द डायग्राम ऑफ एन कन्वेंशनल इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक करंट ट्रांसफार्मर. इट फेथफुली ट्रांसफॉर्म द करंट विदाउट कनेक्शन कब कब लॉस्ट हुआ मेरा कनेक्शन है. हेलो,
अभी अभी
अच्छा अभी अभी हुआ. नाउ कैन एनीवन कैन टेल मी दैट व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट एरर्स इन दिस सीटी एंड पीटी. आई थिंक यू हैव ऑलरेडी रेड इन द मेजरमेंट.
सर फेज एंगल एरर और रेशियो एरर।
या फेज एंगल एरर एंड द रेशियो एरर. सो मेनी टाइम्स you are asked this question, you are asked in the interview also that what are the different errors in this CT and the PT. जब connection lost होगा मेरे को बता दिया करो, क्योंकि मेरे को पता नहीं चलता ना. So there are errors in CT and PT, that is the phase angle error and the ratio angle. Ratio error and फेज एंगल एरर. सो देयर आर सर्टेन एरर्स इन द पीसी. यू कैन दिस इन सीटी एंड द पीटी यू कैन नॉट से दैट इट इज एन आइडियल दैट इज सो बिकॉज ऑफ दीज एरर्स व्हाट एवर वी आर गिविंग इन द प्राइमरी, जो भी हम करंट प्राइमरी को देते हैं वो फेथफुली ट्रांसफॉर्म नहीं करता सेकेंडरी में. देयर इज सम एरर इन द सिस्टम. So, because of the error, we won't say that if we are giving 1000 ampere to the primary and it will faithfully convert to 5 ampere. And that and while this considering the protection circuit, we have to take into consideration these factors also. Now, however, if you see this CT we are using, the two types of CT in the power system. One is the you can say one CT is used for the measuring purposes and second is used for the protection. Now, can anyone can tell me that what's the difference between the two? Difference दोनों में क्या difference है? क्या आप कुछ analyze कर सकते हैं कि दोनों में क्या difference हो सकता है? मीटरिंग सीटी और प्रोटेक्शन सीटी में. सो एनीवन कैन टेल मी. हाँ बताओ, कौन बताएगा? कुछ भी आइडिया हो माइंड में, क्या आप, क्या डिफरेंस है दोनों में?
सेंसिटिविटी सर डिफरेंस होगा था, सेंसिटिविटी उसकी कुछ हाई वगैरह होगी।
अच्छा, और कुछ यानी अदर कुछ ऑपरेटिंग पॉइंट को लेके? ओके, आई विल टेल। इफ यू टेक द केस ऑफ दिस मेजरिंग सिटी एंड दिस प्रोटेक्शन सिटी, आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट विद डायग्राम। नाउ इफ यू सी दैट इफ वी हैव दिस ग्राफ बिटवीन द फ्लक्स डेंसिटी एंड द एक्साइटेशन, दैट इज वी हैव दिस बी एच कर्व। फ्रॉम द बी एच कर्व वी विल सी दैट द ऑपरेटिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द मेजरमेंट सी टी lies near the knee of that, that is lies at the knee of the curve. However, this operating point of the protective CT, it lies well below the knee of the curve. Now, can anyone can tell me that what, how why is it so? Aisa kyun hota hai? Koi bata sakta hai? Any idea? So what happens, a metering CT, if you see the metering CT, or you can say the measurement CT, it is used for the measurement purposes. So it is so designed that in case of the faults, jab bhi fault hoga, it will saturate. Jab zyada current aayega, when the current increases, it will saturate. And as a result, what happens when it will saturate, it save the equipment connected to the secondary due to the damage by an excessive current. So jab current badhega to iska operating point change hoga, lekin change in current bahut kam hoga as compared to change in flux density. This you can say that change in the flux density is very less as compared to that of the change in the current, because if it will saturate, and as a result it will protect the equipment which is connected across it because of the excessive current. So excessive current hoga to uska operating point wo saturate ho jayega aur uska operating point jo hai is line pe lie karega, theek hai. However, if you take the case of the protective CT ka kya case hai, it is faithfully designed, it is designed in such a way it is designed in such a way that it will faithfully reproduce the fault current. So it has to reproduce the fault current whatever the value. So it has to reproduce the fault current faithfully. Ab agar suppose hum protective, agar hamara operating point protective, this operating point yahan hoga to kya hoga ki ye saturate ho jayega. If it is saturate to wo current ki wo kya karega, wo hum ek faithfully uska representation nahi dega hamari kitni current aa rahi hai kitni nahi aa rahi, kyunki wo saturate ho jayega. So these are actually the characteristics, operating characteristics of the both. So here we will have the measurement CT operating point, and here we will have the protective CT operating point. And if you see the graph between the secondary current and the primary current, and this is actually the graph of this protective CT, that is the primary and the secondary current graph, and this is the metering CT. What it does, it first increases, and after the full load current it will start decreasing. Secondary current start decreasing because of the fact for in case of measurement, because it becomes saturated. So this thing we have to take into consideration. So this is the difference between the measuring and the protective CT. So this is the difference between this measuring and protective CT. Now next is the voltage and transformer. However, you have to take into consideration these factors, that and this is the CT that is used for the protection circuit has the standard rating of 1 ampere and 5 ampere. Jo bhi protection circuit ke liye hum CT use karte hain, uski standard rating jo hai 1 ampere hai ya 5 ampere hai. Now next is the voltage transformer or the PT. As you already know, the transformer steps towards the voltage to save for the relaying system and for the personnel to handle that. And if you see the standard secondary voltage on line to line basis, standard secondary voltage for the line to line basis is chosen as 110 volt. That is CTs that PTs that we are using is on line to line basis. Its standard secondary value is 110. It means that whatever the primary को कितनी भी primary value हो हमारी secondary जो हमारी यही standard रहेगा. And 110 is also there in 66.3, I think, because whatever we are using in the labs, it has the secondary value of 66.3. That option, when जब हम उसकी setting कर रहे थे, तो वो option भी हमने देखा. So why we need that? As I already told in the case of CT, because of standardizing the protective equipment. That is, we want to standardize the protective equipment. Irrespective of the value of the primary current, हम इसको standardize करेंगे ताकि उसमें कोई भी primary current हो, secondary हमारी इतनी रहेगी ताकि ये standard हमारा protective system के लिए लगेगा. So as you already know, the PT कहाँ लगता है? It is connected in parallel to the point. यहाँ पे हमें measurement चाहिए where the measurement is desired, unlike the CT which is in series with the line. So similarly, CT, as in CT, if you see, there are errors which are known as this ratio error and the phase angle error. And the ratio error and phase angle errors we have to take into consideration while designing any protective system for that. So this is about the this potential transformer. Now, after that, we will discuss the this primary this protection and the backup protection. As already I told you sometimes that what is the primary protection, what is the backup protection? Can anyone can tell me that what is primary protection and what is backup protection? Can anyone can tell me? कोई बता सकता है primary protection क्या होता है और backup protection क्या होता है? Because we have discussed many times. Yes. Anuj Pratap, can you tell me?
Primary is circuit breaker, sir. And backup is fuse.
No. Any other? What is primary protection and what is the backup protection? Vikas. Vikas Kumar.
सर,
बताओ प्राइमरी और बैकअप क्या होता है? कई बार हमने क्लास में डिस्कस किया है. कौन बताएगा, किसको पता है, कौन बताएगा?
सर, बैकअप प्रोटेक्शन में सर, अगर जो विद इन द जोन सर्किट ब्रेकर लगा होता है, अगर वो रिले लगा होता है, अगर वो फेल हो जाए तो उसके लिए एक दूसरे जोन में जो रिले लगा होता है वो बैकअप प्रोवाइड करता है.
ओके, हम क्या करते हैं कि दो सपोज हमने प्रोटेक्ट करना है किसी ट्रांसमिशन लाइन को. सो व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, वी आर एक्चुअली यूजिंग दिस प्रोटेक्शन रिले फॉर दैट एंड आर द प्रोटेक्शन सिस्टम फॉर दैट. एंड लेट अस सपोज कि हमारा वहां उस लाइन में हमारा जो प्रोटेक्शन सिस्टम है वो फेल हो गया. हम कंसिडर करते हैं कि उस लाइन में हमारा प्रोटेक्शन सिस्टम फेल हो गया, तो दूसरा लाइन का जो हमारा वो है, दूसरी लाइन का जो रिले है हमारा, वो एज ए बैकअप एक्ट करेगा, लेकिन उसका जो टाइम डिले होगा वो ज्यादा होगा एज कंपेयर टू दैट पर्टिकुलर लाइन. दैट वी कैन डिस्कस नाउ. सो this is related to the primary and the backup protection. Is it visible? The screen is visible to you?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. अब क्या होता है, कई बार क्या होता है, वेन एवर वी आर हैविंग द प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन, प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन लेट अस सपोज दैट वी हैव अ लाइन, ओके, एंड वी वांट टू प्रोटेक्ट दैट पर्टिकुलर लाइन एंड यूज द रिले फॉर दैट. सो ये हमारा हो गया इसका प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन. सो वी आर यूजिंग द प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन फॉर दैट. नाउ मेनी ऑफ टाइम्स द प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन फेल्स, कई बार वो फेल हो जाता है. अब फेलियर के कारण क्या हो सकते हैं, रीजंस फॉर द फेलियर क्या हो सकता है? रीजंस फॉर फेलियर हो सकता है करंट ट्रांसफार्मर एंड पोटेंशियल ट्रांसफार्मर, इसका फेलियर हो सकता है, ठीक है, और सर्किट ब्रेकर का फेलियर हो सकता है. उसके बाद रिले, वन ऑफ द मेन कॉजेज बिकॉज ऑफ विच इट फेल्स इज द, इट इज द फेलियर ऑफ ट्रिप बैटरी ऑफ द सर्किट ब्रेकर, दैट वी कैन ऑल्सो डिस्कस. ट्रिप बैटरी मीन्स कि सर्किट ब्रेकर को जो हमने सिग्नल देता है, ट्रिप बैटरी सर्किट है, ट्रिप बैटरी ऑफ सर्किट ब्रेकर, सो इट ऑल्सो फेल्स. सो मेनली इट इज ड्यू टू दैट, एंड दिस ट्रिप बैटरी फेल्स ड्यू टू द इनएडिक्यूट मेंटेनेंस दैट वी हैव. इनएडिक्यूट मेंटेनेंस इट कैन बी ड्यू टू द इनएडिक्यूट मेंटेनेंस. सो लेट अस सपोज दैट इट फेल्स, प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन फेल्स बिकॉज ऑफ दीज रीजंस व्हिच आर स्टेटेड हियर. ये फेल हो जाता है. सो वी नीड द सेकेंड लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस, वी नीड द सेकेंड लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस. अगर ये फेल हो गया तो हम, वरना तो फॉल्स सेपरेट हो जाएगा. क्या करेगा, हमारे पास सपोज फॉल्ट आ गया है यहाँ पे सिस्टम में, तो वो क्या करेगा, ऑल द जनरेटर स्टार्ट फीडिंग दैट. हर कोई जनरेटर जो है सिस्टम है वो फॉल्ट को फीड करना शुरू करेगा, बिकॉज करंट हैज द नेचर दैट इट विल ऑलवेज फ्लो फ्रॉम विद द लीस्ट रेजिस्टेंस. सो वी मस्ट हैव द सेकंड लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस, सेकंड लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस हमारे पास होनी चाहिए इन सच सिचुएशन. सो इन 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 मोस्ट इन सो वी हैव टू प्रोवाइड द अनदर जोन ऑफ प्रोटेक्शन विच शुड ऑपरेट एंड आइसोलेट द फॉल्टी सिस्टम इन केस दिस प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन फेल्स. सो हमारे पास एक सेकेंड लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस होना चाहिए, वो तब वर्क करेगा जब ये फेल हो जाएगा. सो जब ये फेल सिस्टम फेल हो जाएगा, जब ये वाला प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन फेल हो जाएगा उस पर्टिकुलर लाइन का, सो वी मस्ट हैव द सेकेंड लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस फॉर दैट. नाउ इफ यू सी द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन and the secondary protection is that is we can say that the primary protection is not the same protection system as the secondary. It means इसका क्या मतलब है कि suppose हमने differential protection जो use किया है primary के लिए और second है overcurrent protection, so जरूरी नहीं है कि primary protection और secondary protection जो हमारा है वो same हो. so same protective same भी हो सकते हैं और same नहीं भी हो सकते हैं. एंड प्रेफरेबली दिस सेकेंडरी प्रोटेक्शन, व्हाट इज दिस, दिस सेकेंडरी प्रोटेक्शन इज लोकेटेड एट अ प्लेस डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन. लाइक हमारा अगर प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन यहाँ है तो सेकेंडरी प्रोटेक्शन हमारा यहाँ, ये इसके लिए प्राइमरी एक्ट करेगा और इसके लिए सेकेंडरी एक्ट करेगा इस होल ऑफ द लाइन के लिए. और एंड द मेन फ्यूचर ऑफ दिस बैकअप प्रोटेक्शन इज दैट, द बैकअप प्रोटेक्शन का मेन फ्यूचर क्या है, इट विल वेट फॉर द प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन टू ऑपरेट. वो क्या करता है कि इट विल वेट फॉर प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन टू इट विल वेट फॉर द प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन टू ऑपरेट एंड you can say that it will wait for the primary protection to operate, and if the primary protection wall operates, then definitely the secondary protection is coming into picture. Or you can say that wo trip command tabhi deta hai jab primary it will fail. It will give the trip command to the circuit only once the system trip command is given to this this protection, but it will operate only when the primary will maloperate. So what is the future of this secondary protection? If you take the case of the future of this this backup protection or the secondary protection, that is the time delay. Means that is the main feature of the secondary protection is the time delay. What do you mean by time delay? It means that this backup protection, it's actually the time is delayed to for an appropriate amount over the primary protection. So this logic we can provide by only the time delay. That is, we will have delayed the time. We can see, okay, fault is there, but the primary is not operating up to that particular amount of time. Then definitely the secondary will issue the trip command and definitely it will operate. So if you take the case of the time of this backup protection or the secondary protection, so operating time of the secondary protection, it is given by, it is equals to the operating time of the primary protection. Operating time of the primary protection plus operating time of the circuit breaker. So operating time of the primary protection and operating time of the circuit breaker. It means that this feature we have used for the backup protection. Now let us consider a radial system. हमने एक radial system consider किया है. हमारा ये radial system है, generator, source, and then we have along with that we have the transmission lines. We have the transmission lines, and if you see in this case, if you see, this is the relay B and this is the relay A. DTOC is the definite time overcurrent relay. Then when we discuss the overcurrent relay, then definitely we can have this we can discuss in detail what. So you can see that it's a definite time overcurrent relay. So now if you see the relay B, this is the relay B in conjunction with the circuit breaker CB. Relay B circuit breaker CB ke saath, it will acts as a primary protection for BC. ये क्या करेगा? इस लाइन के लिए एज ए प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट कर रहा है. एंड रिले ए अलॉन्ग विद द सर्किट ब्रेकर ए इट प्रोवाइड्स द बैकअप प्रोटेक्शन. इट विल प्रोवाइड द बैकअप प्रोटेक्शन टू द लाइन बीसी. जैसे ये इसको प्राइमरी प्रोटेक्शन प्रोवाइड कर रहा है ये वाला, लेकिन रिले ए अलॉन्ग विद द सर्किट ब्रेकर ए वो क्या कर रहा है, इसको बैकअप प्रोटेक्शन भी प्रोवाइड कर रहा है लाइन बी को. इट मींस दैट इफ यू सी, इफ यू वी हैव प्लॉटेड विद द टाइम, सो दिस इज द टाइम ऑफ डीबी, दैट इज टाइम ऑफ दिस दिस यू कैन से ऑपरेटिंग टाइम ऑफ द रिले एंड द सेलेक्टिव टाइम इंटरवल व्हिच इंक्रीज इंक्लूड्स द टाइम ऑफ द सर्किट ब्रेकर. सो whenever the fault occurs in this line, if you see, whenever the fault occurs in the line BC, this both the primary and the backup relay start operating simultaneously, and in case the primary protection operates successfully, the line BC get de-energized, but the loads on the buses A and B remain intact. It means that agar yahan pe fault aaya to kya hoga, yahi line hum wo karegi, isko hum isolate कर देंगे. However, there are certain cases in which this primary and the backup protection maloperate. So we can discuss that. Now, one case is that. Now, let us suppose that we have this whenever the fault occurs, that is at the fault instant. So primary protection, which is provided by the RB, it starts operating. That is, primary protection of this starts operating and faults occur in this part of the system. That is second part of the system. Let us suppose that fault occurs here. So that primary protection, that is of this RB, it starts operating. Now there is also the backup protection RA. As you see that there is also the backup protection. This relay is providing the backup protection. It means that this backup protection also starts operating. Okay. Now, primary protection means this. Here, the primary protection, that is B, it will issues the trip command to the circuit breaker CB. So it will issue the trip command to this circuit breaker CB. And now, primary circuit breaker start operating. Now, this circuit breaker CB, it will start operating. Now, primary circuit breaker trips. Primary circuit breaker kya karta hai? Trip ho jata hai. It will trip and current returns to the normal value. And when the primary circuit breaker trips, jab primary circuit breaker trip karta hai, backup protection resets. It means that this backup protection resets. So what we analyze from that at the instant of the fault, both the primary and the backup protection, it starts operating. However, the primary protection issues the trip command to the circuit breaker. And if it is operating, that's okay. If it is not operating, what it does, then in that very case, the backup protection RA, it doesn't reset, and as a result, it gives the command to the secondary. It gives the command to the circuit breaker CBA, and this circuit secondary, this backup circuit breaker, it will trip. So this is the normal condition. So in this case, this is the normal condition. However, if you take the case of one faulty condition, let us suppose where our protection system fails. Now, what happens? This is the condition in which our protection system fails. Now, let us suppose that we have the fault instant. Fault start hua. Primary and the primary protection provided by the RB, it starts operating. And the backup protection provided by RA, it also starts operating. It means that whenever the fault occurs, as in the previous case, the primary protection, it starts operating. And the backup protection, it also starts operating. Now, primary protection issues the command to the primary circuit breaker. Okay. And primary circuit breaker starts operating. Primary circuit breaker kya karta hai? Wo operate kar jata hai. Theek hai? Fault ke karan, ye primary circuit breaker jo hai, wo command issue karta hai. Primary relay jo hai, wo command issue karti hai primary circuit breaker ko. To wo operate karna shuru kar deta hai. Okay. However, now what happens? Backup protection also issues the command to the backup circuit breaker. Now, previous case mein kya tha? Normal case mein kya tha? Ki backup protection jo hai, wo ek bar hamara wo operate karna start ho gaya. But it will not issue the command to the backup circuit breaker. It means that it will not issue the command to this CBA. However, in this case, what happens? Ki backup protection इसने कमांड इश्यू कर दी इसको बैकअप सर्किट ब्रेकर को और बैकअप सर्किट ब्रेकर सीबीए वो भी हमारा ऑपरेट करना शुरू हो गया. सो बोथ दिस सीबीबी एंड बोथ सीबीए इट स्टार्ट्स ऑपरेटिंग एंड एज ए रिजल्ट प्राइमरी सर्किट ब्रेकर एंड द बैकअप सर्किट ब्रेकर इट ट्रिप्स. सो दे बोथ द लाइंस विल ट्रिप्ड एंड एज ए रिजल्ट the power in both the lines, that is disturbed because of that. And because of that, what happens? This, we will not provide the load and this power to this particular load. And as a result, we have the, you can say that blackout in at that particular load. So this shows that how that is we can you can say that the proper coordination of the primary and the backup protection is very important. Now, how this primary and the backup protection it can be achieved? This primary and backup protection it can be achieved by relay backup. First one is the relay backup. Second one is the breaker backup. And third one is the remote backup. So what do you mean by relay backup? And in the relay backup, what we have to do, what we have provided, we have provided the duplicate set of primary relays, CTs and PTs. We have provided the duplicate set of primary relays, CTs and PTs. However, it has been observed, अभी देखा गया है कि local backup ये duplicate relays और backup provide करने के लिए we required the local backup at the local station, ताकि हम सारे circuit breakers और relays को open कर सकें. So it is not cost effective, so we won't use this. We won't use this relay backup. It cannot be used. Now, in case of the breaker backup, if you take the case of the breaker backup, if you see, whenever the fault occurs in the feeder, एक fault एक feeder में let us suppose एक occur करता है where the breaker is installed, and if that feeder fails, अगर वो feeder fail कर जाता है, then in that very case, the fault virtually becomes the bus bar fault. So if let us suppose that this we are feeding, this is the feeder, and if this feeder fails, then we can say that the fault virtually becomes, we can assume that the fault becomes the this bus bar fault. So time delay relay is operating from the main relay, and all the breakers emanating from the bus bar are going to trip if the main breaker fails to trip. So this type of this backup is used whenever let us suppose that whenever the fault occurs in the feeder where the breaker is installed, and if that feeder fails, then that fault virtually becomes the bus bar fault, and time delay relay is operated from the main relay. We are operating this time delay from the main relay, and all the breakers emanating from the bus bar, that is which are installed at the feeder, are going to trip if the main breaker fails to trip. Now third one is the remote backup. In case of the remote backup, the backup is actually achieved at, it is achieved by the bus located at the source end. So it is achieved by the bus which is located at the source end. That is, if the load and relay operates, then the source end relay operates. It means that we have provided the relay at the source end, which is also known as the report backup. And let us suppose that the relay is provided at that particular point, and let us suppose that it fails or it operates, then in that very case, the system can be protected by operating the relay which is connected at the source end, which is connected near the source. So this is how we can realize this primary protection and the backup protection. Now tell me, now any questions related to that?
सर रिमोट बैकअप समझा लीजिए एक बार.
ओके.